So today we'll be speaking with a former Amazon employee. His name is Chris Smalls. He's joining us today. Now, Chris Smalls last year actually led protests and walkouts against his former employer, Amazon, due to what he was saying was against the working conditions during the pandemic, failing to protect employees. Chris, thank you so much for joining us today to have this conversation.
Absolutely. Thanks for having me. Appreciate it.
And the reason we're also bringing you in, Chris, is because just last month, the New York's Attorney General, Letitia James, is also moving to sue Amazon. And in her lawsuit, I found it really interesting because she names you in the lawsuit. I'm going to read a quick sentence from the lawsuit. According to Letitia James, New York Attorney General, she says, the company operated with flagrant disregard to workplace safety codes and retaliated against workers like Chris Smalls, who spoke out. In that same lawsuit, two HR employees for Amazon speak out and say, and they call your firing not appropriate and not justified. But really, Chris, really quick, Chris, before we jump into the lawsuit with Letitia James, for our audience who's unfamiliar with your story, describe what happened, describe the work-life conditions at Amazon, what led to you leading these protests, and also what led to your firing.
Absolutely. I started with Amazon in 2015. I came in entry level. Opened up three buildings for them. I started off in New Jersey, EWR9. Then I transferred to BDL2 in Connecticut. And JFK Staten Island was my last building. I was a supervisor for 4 years, after getting promoted fairly quickly within the company. And, the working conditions, these buildings are massive. So you're talking about under a million square feet, 14 NFL football fields. I used to tell my new hires when they came into the facility, if you have a gym membership, you might want to cancel it because it's that strenuous on your body. It's true, Amazon tracks everything down to the second, it's ran completely by metrics. And this is just to give everybody a scope of what we dealt with on a day-to-day basis and I'm still dealing with. So when COVID-19 came into play, I watched my employees come into work last year, flu-like symptoms, dizziness, fatigue. Some were even vomiting at their stations. And it was just a very scary situation when you don't have any PPE, no facial masks, no cleaning supplies. And it was business as usual. So that's what forced me to take further action behind the scenes, sending out emails. I tried to reach Governor Cuomo, tried to reach the mayor. Try to reach the media, but New York City was the epic center. We were overwhelmed and there was no responses from any of these places. So I had to return back to work mid-March. And when I did, my colleague that I work hand in hand with, she was sick to the point where I can see in her eyes. Her eyes were bloodshot. As a friend and a colleague, I told her to go home. Days later, she did test positive, though, but she was there for multiple days in a row. And that same day, we had a meeting and our bosses told us not to tell any of the employees that somebody tested positive 2 weeks prior, not even talking about her situation. So that was my last stance right there working for the company. That's when I decided to come back to the building every single day, organizing workers inside the cafeteria for 10 hours a day, telling them the truth. And by the end of the week, the company decided to quarantine just me and nobody else. Not none of the people in my department, not any of the people that were around in the offices with me, not even the colleague that I ride to work with. So that told me right there that they were targeting me to stop me from organizing workers and telling the truth. So we decided to go through with a walkout on March 30th last year. And 2 hours after that walkout, that's when I was terminated.
Yeah, so according to Amazon, they say they fired you for violating COVID-19 social distancing rules. I'm just going to read a quick quote from the Amazon spokesperson responding to the lawsuit from the New York AG. According to Amazon spokesperson, they say, we do not believe the Attorney General's filing represents an accurate picture of Amazon's industry's leading response to the pandemic. Chris, let me get your response to this. When you heard that New York Attorney General Letitia James was moving to sue Amazon, did that give you some type of hope for your situation?
Yeah, absolutely. I already knew about it before the media did. I've been working with the office the entire time, so she definitely stayed true to her word last year when I got fired. She went out publicly and said there will be an investigation. And she absolutely held up to that promise. She been investigating the entire, it's been 11 months now, almost a year. And I've been working with the office, and I'm happy to see that now it's coming into fruition. You know, I think this will be a huge victory, not just for myself, but for all workers, saying that we can speak up, we can fight back, and we can actually win.
And Chris, as you know, there's a historic union vote happening right now as we speak involving an Amazon warehouse, 6,000 employees in Bessemer, Alabama. Now, do you feel, Chris, if this union vote does pass, it's the first union ever in Amazon's history. But Chris, do you feel that if you were in a union, you would have been protected from this firing?
100%, you know, and that's why I stand in solidarity with the workers in Bessemer. I was just down there in Alabama a week ago. I spent some time with the workers, with the union reps, the leaders, the organizers. And I'm hoping that they are successful so we can galvanize not just up here in New York where my last facility, but all across the nation. Like you said, this would be the first U.S. building in American history to be unionized. And it's rightfully so. It's rightfully needed. We've seen how this company exploit workers over the course of the pandemic. And if we have unions and protections and laws in place to protect workers that we consider essential, what happened to me won't happen to anybody else. So we're hoping that this is a positive outcome at the end of the vote. I'm sorry.
And Chris, a large corporation like Amazon, what are some tactics that you saw while you're working there? What are some tactics that these corporations use to deter employees like yourself from speaking out and protesting? Did you notice any tactics that these companies are using?
Well, yeah. I mean, Amazon is a brainwashing tool, a machine. So I was a part of that machine. You know, even as a supervisor, I was the one that had to track other workers. I had to track my employees in my department. I had to track myself. I had to make sure that I was following rules and regulations of, you know, their policies. And at the end of the day, you know, the way they train, the way they onboard, the way they give assessment tests, you know, these tests all incorporate some type of union busting, either tools or questions. Are some type of messaging that makes you think about, you know, not talking to anybody outside of the company. So, you know, those things I noticed over the course of my tenure there, but I never implied them because I wasn't that type. I was the type that always sided with the employees at entry level. So the tactics that I heard from even the workers of Bessemer, you know, they're putting them in four classes there. They got the website, do it without dues. They did change the traffic lights. All these things are true. The company goes to the extreme measures to keep the union from, you know, forming inside these facilities. So we have to continue to fight back.
Well, Chris, thank you so much for speaking with us today about this important story. And we're going to keep following for the updates, especially the union vote in Alabama and also this lawsuit from the New York Attorney General. So, Chris, thank you so much for that. And to our Daily Caller audience, don't forget to hit that bell down below. So anytime we release any new videos and interviews, you are notified. Chris Moss, thank you so much for joining.
Absolutely, brother. Thank you.